for attending tonight's event, and welcome to the 59th Annual Amy Awards. You've all done an amazing job with all the entries for this year's awards, and this calls for a big celebration. Thank you so much to Keyshawn, who has put this entire event together. She's the beautiful woman sitting over here in red. Amazing job, Keyshawn. Awesome. Thank you. We're celebrating the exceptional work of the marketers who inspire us, marketers whose lifetime achievements add up to lasting legacy, and marketers who show us how we can change the world in using our marketing powers for good. We're celebrating the bright future of Atlanta marketing in our high school and college scholarship winners. None of this celebration would be possible without our sponsors. Don and Liz are going to get up in a little bit and give each of them a special shout out, but thank you. I'd also like to thank my husband, Andy, for allowing me all the time I need to go to the AMA events, to travel and work and do something I honestly love. So thank you. I'd also like to thank our AMA Executive Advisory Board and our Board of Directors. Please stand. Without all of your help and hard work, the AMA Atlanta chapter would not be what it is today. The AMA chapter is the third largest chapter in the country and the largest marketing organization in Georgia. Thank you so much for your commitment to this organization. It means the world to me. Besides the 25 folks that sit on our board, we have over 200 amazing volunteers who spend their spare time helping this make this organization what it is, which is awesome. So now, on with the show. We always kick off the Amy Awards by looking to the future of Atlanta marketing, the winners for our high school and collegiate marketing scholarships. I'd like to introduce Ken Bernhardt, Regents Professor of Marketing Emeritus at Georgia State University and former chair of AMA's National Board. As well as our AMA Atlanta board member, Jessica Mash, paid media specialist at NEBO Agency and Collegiate Regents Chair, who will present tonight's Ken Bernhardt AMA Collegiate Scholarship recipients. Thank you.
Dr. Ken Bernhardt has graciously given his time and resources to the Atlanta community for over the past 40 years. As we come together this evening to recognize and celebrate the best and the brightest marketers in the Southeast, I want to take a moment to recognize the next generation of marketers. Dr. Bernhardt has ensured the future generation has the funding and the resources to cultivate their skills and their talent. While I'm not going to go on some tangent about millennials because I don't want to talk about myself, I can talk from experience that his time and efforts have been the perfect catalyst for young marketers making the transition from college to career. After reviewing applicants from all over the state of Georgia, we have 8 enthusiastic students that are ready to make their mark on the industry. I am honored to present the Ken Bernhardt AMA Outstanding Marketer Award to the following students. Brian So from Georgia Institute of Technology. Danielle Ferguson from Kennesaw State University. Janisha Jones from Georgia State University. And Allie Costley from University of North Georgia. I'd also like to recognize Rachel Levy from Valdosta State University, Avery Taylor from University of West Georgia, and Mary Beth Skinner from Piedmont College, who are unable to join us this evening. Good. Now please welcome Brandy Jansen, Director of Strategic Accounts at ShareThrough, and AMA Atlanta President-elect, and also Rashonda Coleman, Senior Strategic Partnership Manager at Gas South, and AMA Atlanta DECA Chair.
Good evening. We're really excited this evening to highlight two DECA Scholarship Award recipients for our high school seniors. DECA prepares emerging high school students interested in pursuing marketing, entrepreneurship, or finance as they pursue their collegiate career. Each year, Rich and I, we visit 12 to 15 high schools to actually provide the industry certification program. And we interviewed students throughout the state of Georgia and selected two great students to receive a $1,000 scholarship as well as a $500 scholarship.
And we are going to ask our two winners to come to the stage and accept their award, Ashley Suk and Taylor Hancock. Congratulations. Now please welcome Keyshawn Hughes, Senior Product Marketing Manager at Cherwell Software, owner of Event Passion, and chair of tonight's great event, pulled all of this together, of the 2016 AMI Awards. Keyshawn.
Thank you so much, Brandy. Tonight's event is just getting started, but I feel like it has already been a success. We broke records this year and had the most entries ever, 104 submissions. We usually get about 70, so clap for yourselves. You were included in that number. For the first time in the history of this event, we are recognizing and honoring Atlanta's thriving startup community, introducing the city's first Best Marketing and Advertising Tech Startup Award. Common threads of innovation, dedication, and lots of heart will not only be seen in our finalists and winners, but was first displayed by our talented volunteers. From creating tonight's theme and program, soliciting sponsorships, setting up and breaking down the decor, please stay after to help break down the decor, volunteers, to greeting each of you as you walk through the doors today, I couldn't have asked for a better committee of volunteers. They just simply rock. It feels so great to publicly thank you for your creativity, tireless work, dedication, and positivity. So, 2016 AMI Awards committee members, please join me up on the stage at this time to be recognized. Come on up. Don't be shy. Don Dixon, Amanda Brodzik, Don Hill, Abby Gentry Richardson, Brandy Farmer, Jim Reynolds, Michelle Pagot, Nicole Vickers, Carmen Jones, Joshua Ginsburg, Taylor Moore, Alexandria Lowe, Drew Hawkins, Krishan Johnson, and Cindy Marietta. Please join me on the stage. Thank you guys so much. This team put in so much hard work, lots of hours. Thank you all so much for your dedication. I really appreciate you. Thank you for your contributions to AMA Atlanta and the AMI Awards. Let's take a group picture. Thank you. Okay.
You guys want to exit to the left? Yeah, come on. Aw, she missed it. One more picture with Krishan.
Or Nicole. Come on. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Yes. Thank you all. At this time, I'd like to ask Don Hill, AMI Awards volunteer and AMA Atlanta Mentorship Chair, and Liz Farquhar, AMA Atlanta Sponsorship Chair, to introduce and thank our sponsors.
Thanks, Keyshawn. And before we go into that, quickly, I'd like to invite Anna Howe to the stage, a senior at University of Georgia, who's also a Ken Bernhardt Scholar, to get her award. She was on the slide, but did not come up to the stage yet, so let's appreciate her. Thank you, Anna. So thanks so much to our sponsors. Liz, I'll let you go ahead and start.
Thank you again to everyone who helped make this night possible. And those people include, but are not limited to, Nebo, a diamond sponsor. AT&T, Platinum and Cocktail Hour sponsor. Friendly Human, Clear Channel, FSI, C3 Agency, Innovative Marketing and Design, True Language, and Stir Marketing. Rocket Fuel, of course, Cardinal Web Solutions, and BKV.
We'd also like to thank Sharewell Software, Atlanta Tech Village for hosting our judging day, the Atlanta Braves, Inbox Marketer, Concourse Athletic Club, the Visionary Design Group, Crave Pie Studio, Unit 2 Fitness, Fox Theater, Brown Foreman, Christoph's To Go, Brewmont Total Flooring Solutions, Glen Hotel, Share This, Angel Auctions, Atlanta Photographers, Revelry Photo House, Encyclomedia, Iris Worldwide, and Union Diamond. Thank you so much.
We would have never gotten to this point of honoring tonight's finalists and winners without the important work of our distinguished panel of judges. Toby Bloomberg, co-founder of Diva Foodies, Elizabeth Club, founder and principal of Kismet Associates, Rob Cruz, CMO of Rob Cruz Marketing LLC, Don Dixon, partner with Lifestyle Marketing Group, Gerard Green, Vice President of Product Marketing for Sharewell Software, Jeff Hillmeyer, co-founder and CEO of Dragon Army, Vicki Jones, VP of Brand Strategy and Creative at Phase 3, Joe Kaufman, founder of Agency Sparks, Rebecca Messina, Vice President of the Coca-Cola Company, Kristen Peters, Account Manager at Conversant, Jim Reynolds, Digital Marketing, Communications, Analytics, and Brand Management Consultant. Scott Saffon, former EVP, Chief Marketing Officer of the Weather Channel. Moira Vetter, Chief Executive Officer of Motomoto Agency. Give all of our judges a round of applause. Thank you all for dedicating your time and expertise to this year's AMI Awards. Now, let's play the judging day video for a behind-the-scenes look at how the winners were selected by this talented group of judges.
Thank you. judging awards in a multiplicity of marketing categories.
We're seeing more and more the influence of technology in the awards. The digital landscape is kind of leveling the playing field. And I think increasingly you're seeing more and more like better work being done by smaller companies.
I do think that when the risks are high and the market is tough, some of the best things happen, and I really see that in the work today.
This year, it seems like the entries are more focused on results.
Creative has always sort of been in Atlanta, but it's nice to see results coming to the forefront. So I've been very impressed by the award so far.
Today, making your mark is less about having the world know who you are and more about having the people who will love your brand know who you are.
I think it's harder than ever to make your mark. And so when you can do it, I think you've engaged people with your head and with your heart. I think the work somehow moves the needle. I think it somehow leaves an impression, but more importantly, it leaves people wanting more.
Throughout the evening, we will use Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram to select people in this room to win great prizes, including gym passes, sporting event tickets, cash, and more. C3 Agency, Innovative Marketing and Design, Stir Marketing, and True Language are partners with us in this contest and have representatives in the room tracking your social media posts. To enter the drawing, all you need to do is post using the hashtag MakeYourMarkATL and follow the directions attached to your selfie sticks that are at your tables. The more you post, the more chances you have to win. Now I will announce our first round of winners. If I call your name, please make your way to the awards table to the right of the stage to claim your prize. Margaret Lisi, where are you? Stand up and be counted. All right, you're our first winner. Congratulations, you've won a $100 gift card to the Queen and Queen at 8 Salon. Go over to the right to the gift table. There are many more chances to win tonight, so please keep using the hashtag MakeYourMarkATL. Now it is my pleasure to introduce our host for the evening. He is the president and CEO of the Atlanta Convention and Visitors Bureau and has been honored as one of Atlanta's most 50 admired CEOs for the last 2 years. This is his sixth year hosting the Amy Awards. Please join me in welcoming our MC for the evening, William Pate.
Hi, good evening, everybody, and welcome to Marketing's Greatest Night in America's Greatest City. And we're gonna have a lot of fun here this evening. I want to start out by congratulating all the award winners and the finalists. I know that they said we had more entries than we've ever had, and I know we've seen some great work. In this city, the marketing in this city is great, and it's great to have that recognized. Now, we're going to do things a little differently this year, so pay attention so you don't get humiliated, because you know I will humiliate you if you mess this up. When the finalist names are called, we ask everybody's going to stay seated. And when the winner is announced, a representative from the winning organization is going to come up to the stage over here to my right, your left, to accept your award. Then we're going to have give them the opportunity to say a few words before the music begins, and that's going to be your signal to move on. And we want to keep this on schedule. Ken Bernhardt's already told me he doesn't want to miss American Idol tonight, so we got to get this moving, make sure that we don't dawdle. So as you hear the music, finish up your speech and make your way off. The runners up, as the winner comes down the steps here, and you're going to pause to get a photo, the runners up can then make their way to my left, your right, for another photo as well. So. Everybody got that? Winners come up. Second place and beyond goes to my left. Two photos, and we'll keep this thing going, all right? Is anybody here from Arkansas? Do I need to repeat that again? Okay, I know we got one from Arkansas in the back, David Healy. But he's got a bodyguard, so he won't mess it up, I know. Now, I also want to remind everybody to post and follow the event on social media using the hashtag MakeYourMarkATL. MakeYourMarkATL. Don't say MakeYourMarkBirmingham because then you're not going to win any damn prize. So MakeYourMarkATL. And remember, our social media contest is going to continue throughout the evening, and there are going to be several great prizes to win. So we're here to give out statues. Let's start by giving out our first statue. The first category is broadcast advertising, TV and radio. We have three finalists, 22 Squared for Vormax, the Morrison Agency for Be the Solution campaign, and Argonaut, How Cricket Wireless Won Big by Acting Small. And the winner of our first award, 22 Squared for Vormax.
So I'm gonna keep this well under a minute, but thank you to everyone who's putting on this show. Thank you for all the sponsors. Thank you for the great salad. I look forward to the rest of the dinner. But most of all, thank you to a very brave client with a very good sense of humor. And thank you to the team who can't be here tonight. Appreciate it. Hope you guys have a great evening.
That was done flawlessly. Richard, you're training them well. That's awesome. The second award is digital advertising, online and website sponsorship. And the finalists are search discovery, strategic, Strategic tagging and segmentation drives explosive growth and targetable users for dynamic remarketing. Primrose Schools. School is in. Good job. Science and Seesaw's digital advertising campaign. And Sapient Nitro. There we go. The next project. And the winner is Sapient Nitro, the next project.
So I come before the next course, but thank you. I actually have to thank my colleagues who really worked hard in building such a great relationship with our client, Regions Bank, for the last 5.5 years. Awesome partner, and we're going to continue to do great work for them, but enjoy the rest of the night. Thanks.
Our third category is email marketing. And the BKV and AT&T, Cyber Monday email, powering 4 times the promotions in a single send. And one of the great ways to make sure you're gonna win a category is when you're the only nominee. So BKV and AT&T, Cyber Monday email, powering 4 times the promotion in a single send. Come on down.
Thank you to everybody who didn't enter the email category. And thank you to our client AT&T who lets us do some very cool things with email.
Okay, we're gonna have a series of guest presenters as we go through the evening. They cut my salary in half, so I'm only gonna be up here half the time. So the first guest presenter is actually two, Jackie Biggs, the Director of Business Development at Skyline Southeast, and Jack Jessen, President and General Manager of Clear Channel Outdoor. They're gonna present our next award.
I gotta turn your page for you.
Appreciate that.
I don't want you to award the wrong thing.
We don't wanna do that either.
Thank you, William, and hello, everyone. So we're here to present the award for print advertising, newspapers, magazines, and other. The finalists are Denmark, the agency, for Georgia Transplant Foundation Latino Outreach Campaign for Kidney Transplant, 22 Squared for DXV, and Allied Integrated Marketing, Fox Theater's 40th anniversary of Save the Fox, Atlanta Magazine Special Section.
And the winner is 22 Squared DXV.
What's going on here? Okay, now you can hear me. Thank you very much to the clients again for again choosing some very bold work, and I look forward to whatever comes after the salad. Kind of pins and needles here. Thanks.
Jackie and Jack from Skyline Southwest and Clear Channel, which are both silver sponsors for this year's award. So please join me in thanking them for their support of the AMI Awards. Now, somebody told me the acoustics in here aren't very good, so if you don't mind, I'm going to start over because I don't want you to have missed that great opening that I had. So I'm just kidding. Several people in the back were already walking to the exit when they heard that. Now we're going to pause and select the next winners of our social media contest. I told you that was going to go through all night. So Amanda Brodzik and Michelle Pigot are going to come up and hopefully hand me a piece of paper. Stacy William. Please go to the, congratulations, Stacy. Go to the awards table here on the left and you can get your prize, which is a gift package from Concourse Athletic Club that includes 1 month of gym access, a 30-minute massage, hey now, and a 30-minute personal training session. Stacy William. We have a second winner coming this way. No, don't play the music now. I'm not supposed to leave. That's for people who are getting the award. If they're talking too long, you can't play the music on me. I'm like a third of the way through here. All right, let's move on to the direct mail marketing, two or three dimensional printed mailings. We have three finalists. Motomoto Agency for Unblocks Dimensional Mailer. Woohoo! BKV, low cost, high response, Aflac BKV Industries specific direct mail campaign. And Piedmont Healthcare, Piedmont Clinic Value and Vision, wow. Summit Direct Mail campaign. And the winner is Motomoto Agency, Unblocks Dimension Mailer.
Okay. And we'd just really like to thank everyone for this award. We're really proud that it's our own work that we're winning for. And I appreciate that the entire team had a hand in this concept. So thank you very much.
Good. Now it's my pleasure to introduce another presenter, Emily Tungala. She's the senior producer of Friendly Human. And here she is. Thank you.
The following finalists invested $100,000 or more in these events. Georgia World Congress Center Authority for the Vibe Bus Project, a literal marketing vehicle promotion for Kenny Chesney's The Big Revival Tour. C3 Agency for Cathay Pacific Airways, history-making inaugural launch of the nonstop flight from Hong Kong to Boston. And CSE for the Atlanta United team launch. And the winner is Georgia World Congress Center Authority.
Give it up for Team Vibe Bus. I would like to thank our partners with Savannah College of Art and Design and all the members of Team Vibe Bus. And since this was all about a Kenny Chesney show, I'd have to quote an appropriate verse, which is, "We captured lightning in a bottle. Somehow we survived it all." And how's that next line go? "Oh, the stories we could tell if this bus could talk." Thank you all very much.
Hi, I'm now going to introduce the event marketing event over $100,000 investment. The finalists are, oh, wait a minute, hold on. Sorry. This is the event under $100,000 investment. The finalists are 22 Squared Peace Day, ARPR, cutting through the clutter with FitNet at CES, the tech industry's Super Bowl, ARPR Next Defense at RSA, driving qualified leads at minimal cost. And the winner is 22 Squared Peace Day.
So actually have to thank McDonald's for bowing out of the challenge that Burger King gave them to create the Peace Whopper, or the Peace Burger. We took advantage of that situation, and it turned out to be a great campaign. So thanks, everyone, again.
This is going fabulously, don't you think, so far? Okay. Now, we have one problem. The people who are the finalists are not going over and picking up their finalist awards. So if you're a finalist, you still get an award. We just give it to you way over there so nobody can see you. So make sure you go over there and get the award, because, I mean, they're already paid for. So I'm going to make sure that you get that. So our next award is for marketing analytics and data visualization. We have two finalists: search discovery, data visualization drives campaign agility and performance for Apartment Finder. I'm not sure that's all going to fit in an award. I hope we have a big award for that. And Mellow Mushroom, email marketing insights. And we're going to need that big award, because the winner is search discovery, data visualization drives campaign agility and performance for Apartment Finder.
Okay, thank you so much, everybody. This is awesome. First of all, I'd like to thank really the Apartment Finder team, especially Stuart Richens, the CoStar team, including Andy Florence and Fred Saint and everybody over there, but especially everybody at Search Discovery, Lindsay Blankenship, for being a career coach and a supervisor to all of us, for Lee Blankenship, Mike Gustafson, Yehonatan, Aaron, Drew, Tori, Farouk, Gabriella, there's an enormous amount of you, Olivia, you're at that table, and just really everybody is an amazing, amazing opportunity, and I especially want to thank my wife for giving me the opportunity to work with these incredible people and do awesome, awesome things. So thank you, everybody.
All right, great job. Now we're going to have another special presenter. Please join me in welcoming Alex Torrey, the co-founder of Umano and 2015 Marketing for Good Award recipient.
Hello, good evening. So they threw a little curveball, and we're ahead of schedule, I think. But I am very, very happy to be here because of what I get to do today. And I don't know how many of you know Kate, but if you don't know her, I would strongly encourage you to get to know her. So Kate has not only impacted the lives of a lot of kids, she has impacted the lives of a bunch of adults. And it's, I think that is something that I can speak. My brother and I both know the roller coaster ride that it is to start something. And Kate started Kate's Club. Kate's Club is an organization for kids who have lost a parent or a sibling, and they do incredibly amazing things. So you'll get to watch a little bit of a video that'll tell you more about that.
Kate's Club is an organization here in Atlanta that empowers children and teens who are facing life after the death of a parent or a sibling. And Kate's Club is very special to me because I lost my mother, Audrey, when I was 12 years old. And when I looked around to find just another friend, another peer who had a similar loss, I couldn't find anyone. I started Kate's Club 12 years later, and I'm just really, really proud of how far that organization has come. Now we serve over 1,000 children a year here in the metro region and continue to grow every day. So Choose ATL is the new initiative out of the Metro Atlanta Chamber that exists to attract and retain millennial talent.
At first, it just seemed like this concept that we couldn't achieve, and everything is, she's just helped put everything in place. She sees that this is different, this is unique, and that we have a chance to make Atlanta bigger and greater and to attract the best people here. And she wants to do that by bringing the community together.
And it's not just about hustle here. You can go to a lot of cities and as a young person work really, really hard, but here people help you. And that's the story of Kate's Club. You know, I was 23 years old. I wasn't from Atlanta. I didn't have money. I didn't even really have a network. I just wanted to change the world for the better. And people in Atlanta helped me do that. You know, making a difference is one of the top priorities of the next generation. And I just can't think of a more promising spot than Atlanta to do that. I'm very lucky that I now get to be the person that shares that with the world.
Kate?
There's a song. Thank you so much. What an amazing honor. I'm so grateful to Atlanta, really. I'll tell you a little story about my first, probably my hardest marketing experience when I was young and starting Kate's Club. And that was to get the first three or four families to join our club. I remember so specifically walking into these coffee shops, and I had everything that a marketer should have. I had this slick logo, I had this one pager all about what the mission and the vision was of Kate's Club. And I would walk in and I would meet these families, and the parents would just push the materials aside, and they would say, "I just want you to tell my kids your story. I just want them to see somebody who's made it and who's okay." And I think every day as marketers, we have the choice to look at every story we wish to tell in that way, authentically, certainly passionately, but for good. And I'm so honored that now I get to continue that with a mission and a narrative around our beloved ATL. You know, Choose ATL is out there sharing our story with the world in a way that will attract the people that we want to move here, the people that will make this city better. And I feel great every day that I can stand on a platform and tell a story for good, can tell a story that is about a city that, as a young person, you can come here and you can make a difference. As I said in the video, you can go a lot of places as a young person and hustle. But I was 23 years old. I had no cash. I had no network. I didn't have a degree. I had nothing that said that Kate's Club would work, except I had people and community that surrounded me, and that's the story of Kate's Club. So on behalf of all of the kids at Kate's Club and all of the wonderful stories out there that need to be told for good, including our own as Atlantans, thank you so much.
Kate's got a great story, and she's a great person to work with. When she was at Arby's, she ran the foundation, and she called me one day and asked me if I'd be on the board, which I said I'd be very happy to do. And like about 3 days later, she called up and said, "Hey, I'm going to the chamber, so see you later." She's done great work, and for those of you who haven't seen the Choose ATL campaign, it's targeted to millennials. It's really brilliant work, and it's a wonderful complement to what we do at the ACVB. We're trying to get people to visit the city, and most of what we do is targeted, as you know, to conventions. And so to have a message out there to millennials, which also encourages them to visit our city, is really powerful stuff, and the Chamber's wonderful partners and Kate and her team do a great job. So it's a great opportunity to award somebody who's really doing good in the Atlanta community. So let's move on to another category. This is a new award category called Marketing and Advertising Tech Startup. And it really echoes the goals that were expressed in the Choose ATL campaign. And AMA wanted to create a new AMI Award category to showcase Atlanta's unique startup culture. We're very happy to recognize four finalists in this category as trailblazers that are making their mark in Atlanta's startup scene. Our first finalist is Terminus for flipping the funnel with account-based marketing. Second is Inbox Pros, email deliverability consulting monitoring solution. Argus from Astadia, Argus augmented reality. I need some more augmented reality. I'd like to see you after we're done. And Hypopotamus for hypopotamus.com. And these are all startups. And the winner is Terminus, flipping the funnel with account-based marketing.
Terminus is actually the original name of the city of Atlanta. So super proud to have to doing it.
It feels like Atlanta has been really, really nice when it comes to talent, when it comes to culture, and when it comes to passion for the problem we want to solve.
When we started, it seemed like an underserved market, sort of B2B advertising. There was a couple players in the space.
We feel a big problem is that in B2B companies, less than 1% of leads become customers.
So what we are doing here at Terminus is building an account-based marketing platform that's going to help B2B marketers drive more of those leads into customers.
And so what our software does is help them going from kind of filtering through a funnel to focusing on the best fit accounts, finding more people, engaging them on more channels, and getting customers more efficiently.
It's that approach that's helped Terminus to get to over $1 million in annual recurring revenue as fast as we have, because everybody is aligned on driving revenue into the business.
I think it's exciting times for us, and I think this year is gonna be especially exciting. We're building something far bigger than what we have today.
All right, thank you so much. I guess three people with capes here, we obviously got the memo that this is no tie event. So thank you for letting us come in. We're super excited. This is actually to these guys, Nikki and Lauren from marketing team at Terminus. This is to you guys. Let's flip funnels. Thank you so much. All
right. I don't know about y'all, but I wish I had a cape. Because I think if you wear a cape to an event, people pay attention to you. And if you've got some superpowers, I'd like to know about those. Does this come with superpowers? I may need some superpowers when we get out of here. Yeah, I noticed him when we were at the bar. And I said, that guy's got a cape on and we're at the beginning of the cocktail hour, which made me a little bit nervous, But look, now you got an award, so it's awesome. Remind everybody again, if you're a finalist, make sure you go over and pick up your award. Your right, my left. Our next category is integrated marketing campaign for general market B2B. We have three finalists. Everywhere Agency, Marketing Emmy Domains with Influence Marketing and Conference Sponsorship. Interface, Beautiful Thinking Campaign. And the Moto Agency, Argus X-Ray Vision for Field Teams. And the winner is the Moto Agency, Argus X-Ray Vision for Field Teams.
Sorry, we're running behind. I was going to get our finalist awards when we got this. So our other award was for ourselves. This is for a client we've been working very, very hard for. And again, really appreciate the team coming together to make this account a success.
Okay, I'd like to take a quick poll. How many people think that Moto and 22 Squared have won enough awards for the evening? Anybody? Okay. All right. Good deal.
The next category is integrated marketing campaign for general market B2C with company revenue under $1 billion. Three finalists. The Aspire Group for unleashing the Zolos in Tijuana. 22 Squared for Save the Americans. And Communications 21 for Meals on Wheels, Atlanta turns 50. You want to guess who won? 22 Squared. Save the Americans.
Thank you. You're probably getting sick of me, so I'm going to keep this really short. Thank you to a really brave client and also a great country. Really proud to do work for them. If you haven't been there, it's a beautiful place, and you need to visit because you guys look really overworked. So thank you.
We're really moving ahead of time, although I see the food's coming out, because it would be bad form to be finished before anybody gets to eat anything. So I'm going to slow it down. All right, thank you, whoever's clapping out of pity for that joke. Thank you so much. Yes, that was, no, I. Okay, the next category is integrated marketing campaign, general market B2C. Company revenue over $1 billion. First finalist is Piedmont Healthcare, Living Better, integrated marketing campaign. There you go. Cardinal Web Solutions, Papa John's integrated marketing campaign. And Hill and Knowlton Strategies, one day pay, submit today, smile tomorrow with Aflac. And the winner is? Piedmont Healthcare, Living Better, integrated marketing campaign.
Can I get a woo woo? So this is really exciting. This Living Better campaign is amazing. It's about giving people a way to live better, taking tiny steps, which is a relatively revolutionary concept in healthcare. So on that front, I'd like to thank Matt Gove and Katie Logan for letting us think out of the box. Woo! And the amazing team who got behind this campaign and made it all possible. There's three entire tables of people. Thank you all so much. Woo!
Okay, next we're gonna have a yelling contest. The first finalist is Piedmont Healthcare. Well, there you go, yes, that's. Okay. Okay, we're going to try and do the social media contest again, and I'm going to kind of give that a second. Here we go. Excellent. The first winner. Okay, Braves tickets to Kevin Nwankwor. I am really sorry if I'm butchering that name. Kevin Nwankwor. Here he comes, in the back. Okay, the next gift is tickets to see Britt Floyd. And the winner is Kimmy Wingo. Kimmy Wingo, off to your left to pick up your prize. Now, because we're all in marketing, I know when you walked in, the first thing you noticed was that margarita machine. And that deserves a yell. And we're going to give that away right now. So the margarita machine, and I'm sure a party at this person's house as soon as we're done, Jamie Donaldson. Jamie Donaldson's getting the margarita machine. This is $100 cash. It doesn't get better than that from Innovative Marketing. And the winner is Rena Cook. Rita, you got to go over there and pick up your $100. They're not going to bring it to you. This is $100 cash from C3 Agency to Anna Ruth. All right. Anna's going, oh, my God, they're calling my name. Am I supposed to go up and do something? Yes, you're supposed to present the next award. And $100 cash from True Language
to Lori Bowman. Nothing plays like cash. The next category is B2B visual branding identity. And the finalist, and therefore the winner, is Cardinal Web Solutions for Vizix rebranding.
First of all, we'd like to thank the client for being a fantastic partner and letting us run with this idea. What was up on the screen was actually the before, not the after. We'd also like to thank our CEO and the leadership team for taking us down this path. And last of all the marketers from Cardinal who couldn't be here tonight.
And I promise I'd say thank you to our office dog, Leroy, who keeps us stress-free. So thank you, Leroy.
Okay, our next category is another new award category for Best Overall Entertainment Campaign. This category provides us with an opportunity to celebrate Atlanta's booming entertainment industry and AMA Atlanta's innovation in being the first AMA chapter in the country to establish the Entertainment Marketing Special Interest Group. First chapter in the country. That's worth a clap, yeah. Our category winner is an exciting example of the opportunities and resources that abound in Atlanta's unique entertainment culture. And the winner is Allied Integrated Marketing for Nitro Circus Live. And we're going to have a video as they come up to get their award.
Nitro Circus Live is an action sports spectacle featuring over 40 of the world's biggest and best action sports athletes.
Nitro Circus Live is definitely one that we enjoyed. It's more in our wheelhouse as a company by being live entertainment focused.
In working on Nitro Circus Live, we had to put a team together that had different areas of expertise.
Our media team, our marketing team, and our PR team all work together to develop a cohesive plan and an integrated campaign that maximizes results for our clients.
We had some great partners come on board. We worked with local businesses, some universities, some professional sports teams, and some other local organizations that really brought a lot of value to the table for the client, and we were very grateful for the partnership.
Atlanta's really become a melting pot of cultures.
There's just a lot of different people coming from a lot of different backgrounds to settle in the area, and they all tend to have different interests, and I just think there's a lot to appeal to from a show's perspective.
Thank you so much. It's such an honor to represent Allied in accepting this award for the first ever entertainment marketing campaign. Entertainment marketing is really the core of what we do at Allied, and so we're just thrilled that the AMA has recognized what a hotbed Atlanta is for entertainment by adding this category. I'd like to thank everyone on my team for being so talented and dedicated. Thanks to Nitro Circus and all of our great clients for being allowing us to work on some really fun and exciting events. And also I'd like to recognize all of the staff at the Georgia Dome, the Fox Theater, and all of the many venues and theaters in Atlanta. You guys play a huge role in attracting some great events to this city. And while we're all sitting back and relaxing and enjoying the show, you guys are working tirelessly behind the scenes to make it all possible. So thanks.
I'm gonna look at the president here as we're ahead. Do you want to take a break? We're at a good point. If you want to take like a 15-minute break, everybody can get their food. Is that? Oh, no, they want to keep it. Never mind. I'm sorry. I'm getting. Okay, our last award. No, I'm just kidding. Okay. This is the last call for silent auction bids for those of you who are interested in the silent auction. If there's an item that you want, this is your last chance to bid for it, so make sure you go back and do your bids for silent auction. Proceeds from the silent auction are going to support AMA Atlanta initiatives. So place your final bid at the silent auction tables and claim your prize here at the end of the evening. Now it's my pleasure to introduce Damon Borosny from the Nebo Agency, and he's going to present our next award.
All right, so just go to figure that right when I come up, the food gets served. For B2C visual branding identity, the finalists are Mellow Mushroom, House of Shroom. Treebird Branding, W.H. Styles Fish Camp. Piedmont Healthcare and Brown Bag Marketing co-submission. Living Better Visual Branding. Keep it going. Come on up. Y'all won. Piedmont Healthcare, Brown Bag.
So this is exciting. We owe a lot of the credit to our visual brand identity on this campaign to Brown Bag, who was able to take the crazy that was in our head and turn it into something truly amazing. So thank you, guys.
I just want to say Piedmont kicks ass. Thank you.
Thank you, Damon. Nebo's the graphic designer and web development sponsor for this year's award, so please join me in thanking Nebo for their support of the AMI Awards. Okay, now they've decided that taking a break would be a good idea. So we're going to take 15 minutes, let everybody get their food, if you want to refresh your alcoholic drink, and we'll be back up to finish out in about 15 minutes, okay? Okay, everybody. The bad thing about taking a break is now I've got to get control again, so... We have a few more things to do, and then we're going to have plenty of time for socializing. First thing I'd like to do is ask Rachel Levy to come up. She wasn't here when we presented the Ken Bernhardt Awards, and we wanted to recognize her. So, Rachel, you can clap for Rachel. Where is Rachel? Here she comes. Another Ken Bernhardt Scholarship recipient. So congratulations, there you go. Okay, we really are making the turn for home, so appreciate everybody working with us on that little break. So our next category is web campaign microsite for company revenue over $1 billion. And we have three finalists. Piedmont Healthcare, Cancer Wellness Online, Microsites, Web Campaign. Did y'all get extra drink tickets over there? Okay. Launch Interactive, Pardo Interactive Guided Tour. And Sapient Nitro, The Next Step Project. And the winner is Sapient Nitro, The Next Step Project.
Thank you very much. Just want to quickly thank our client, Regions Bank, and some clients over there that allowed us to do some really creative stuff. Jill Adams, Ben McLeod, Brett Pippin, and the CMO at Regions, Michelle Elrod. And also our creative team, our executive creative director, Bill Pauls, creative director, Reed Koss, and our account director, Gloria Semeoa. Thank you very much.
Okay, now it's my pleasure to introduce Brandi Jessen to come to the podium for the Lifetime Achievement presentation.
Okay, so I am going to slow things down a little bit. So each year, the AMA Atlanta presents the Lifetime Achievement Award to an individual who has distinguished themselves by making significant and long-lasting contributions to the field of marketing throughout their career. Tonight's Lifetime Achievement Award is being presented to David Christopher. David is the Chief Marketing Officer for AT&T Mobility. In recognition of his vision, inspiration, and leadership in mobile communications and its place in today's marketing ecosphere. David has served as a CMO for AT&T Mobility since 2004 and is recognized as being a thought leader in the communication industry. He is responsible for the development and execution of AT&T Mobility's marketing vision and is driven by a passion for delivering customer value directly into the hands of AT&T's 120 million plus wireless customers each and every day. David also serves as the chairman of the board of directors of Ad Council, a private nonprofit volunteer organization that delivers critical messages through PSA campaigns addressing critical social issues such as chronic absenteeism in schools, as well as the dangers of texting while driving. In addition to having been named to the 2014 list of Forbes' 50 most influential CMOs, David serves on both the Facebook and Twitter Client Council, an invitation-only group of industry leaders that provide social networks with input on advertising and marketing. A native of Winston-Salem, North Carolina, David earned his bachelor's degree from the University of Virginia and a master's of business administration from the Kellogg School of Northwestern University. Unfortunately, David is not able to join us tonight, but he still wanted to express his sincere thanks and gratitude through this video.
David's impact in our business is absolutely remarkable. If you look at back when we first merged with AT&T Wireless, our company had roughly 24 million customers. By the end of 2014, if you look at that 10-year span, we have over 120 million customers. How many chief marketing officers can say they drove revenues 3x?
You know exactly where you stand when you're working with David. But I think the thing that I appreciate the most for him, and maybe what we've taken away, is that David really treats this as a true partnership working with the agency. He understands that the more immersed we are in his business, the better we can do, and the better the work's gonna get.
We have an incredible, innovative team. There's a sense of urgency in what we do. Our industry is very busy. It changes daily, and you know we're on it every day. I have the luxury and the honor of working with such an incredible team. And this really is a accolade and a recognition to them. You know, I am lucky to be here and I'm very honored, but the team is who deserves the credit. I'm so honored to receive this award, but it really is a team award. I've had the honor of working with incredible individuals my entire career, so thank you to them. I also want to thank the AMA. You do so much for marketing, you do so much for our community, and it really is a true honor and privilege to be with you tonight, albeit not personally. I want to also congratulate all the other winners tonight. Thank you so much.
Accepting the award for David is Jonna Dusich, Vice President and Chief Marketing Officer for Cricket Wireless.
Thank you so much. I'm Jonna Dusich, and I am very proud to accept this award on behalf of David Christopher. He, as he said in the video, he's really sorry he can't be here. He's actually out of the country with his family, which I think we can all appreciate. But he's really honored by being recognized by the AMA for his career achievements. I've personally known David for over 10 years. And as the head of marketing for Cricket Wireless, I've had the pleasure of working really closely with him every day. I can tell you firsthand that he is truly deserving of this award. As a CMO for AT&T Mobility, David leads marketing for AT&T's consumer wireless business. And most recently, he was also named as the CMO for not only Mobility, but also the AT&T Entertainment Group. But as impressive as his credentials are, his accomplishments as a leader and a mentor are even more noteworthy. He has been a mentor to me, and he taught me to be an insight-driven marketer. My team can tell you that I absolutely live by that. And has really served me well throughout my career. But David not only delivers on the brands that he represents, he delivers for the people that he represents. He's made a lasting contribution to our profession and a lasting impression on those he leads, serves, and partners with. So again, on behalf of David Christopher and AT&T, I'd like to accept this award and thank the AMA and the Amy Awards for this great honor. Thank you.
Thank you, Jonna, and please tell David we pass along our congratulations. I think it's really appropriate he should get the Lifetime Achievement Award. I was the CMO at Bell South for 12 years, and that felt like a lifetime, so I think it's definitely appropriate that he should get that award. Okay, our next category is Marketing Analytics, Analytics Application. And we have a finalist and we have a winner. Search Discovery, the American Cancer Society, scores user behavior and cancer.org to identify optimization opportunities. Search Discovery.
Thank you. Thank you all so much. I'd first like to thank everyone here who did not submit an entry to this category. Wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for you. But seriously, thank you to everyone at Search Discovery for teaching me that analytics is more of an art than a science. We've got an awesome team, people who are always challenging us to be creative and do things differently. And thank you to the American Cancer Society, Shamir, for always being supportive and willing to be our guinea pig when we want to try new things. So thank you so much.
Okay, we're getting down to the winners who didn't go to graduate school. So remember, when you win, exit that way, so you can get your picture made, okay? Okay. Our next category is web and interactive marketing, consumer engagement. We have two finalists, Mellow Mushroom, A Song of Stone and Slice, and Allied Integrated Marketing, Star Wars, The Force Awakens, Coffee Carts at Georgia Tech. And the winner is Mellow Mushroom, A Song of Stone and Slice.
Thank you. We beat Star Wars, so I don't think there's really anything else to say. Thank you.
Okay, we have another social media winner, King and Queen at 8 Salon. And the winner is Jordan Garofalo. Jordan Garofalo. Proceed to stage right and pick up your King and Queen at 8 Salon certificate. Our next category is lead generation and e-commerce. And the finalists are Launch Interactive, North Highland Website Redesign, and ARPR, If You Optimize, They Will Come, Improving AssureSign Lead Generation and SEO Strategies Garnered 3 Site Conversions per day. That's a lot to get on an award, and you're the ones who won it. So come on down, ARPR. If you optimize, they will come. Improving AssureSign lead generation and SEO strategies garnered 3 site conversions per day. I got all that out before you got here.
Hey, thank you guys so much. Thanks to AMA. So I have to tell you guys, I recently moved from Atlanta to Savannah, and there is nothing like AMA in Savannah. So I really miss coming to these things, so you guys should be taking advantage of all the great AMA events if you're not. And second, thanks to all the awesome ARPR team and to AssureSign, who has really helped us if we've moved from a traditional PR agency into lead generation and marketing automation. They're a great client to go along on this journey with, so thanks.
Okay, our next category is innovation and market research. And this is another one that scared all the competition away. The winner is Hill & Knowlton Strategies, the 2015 AFLAC Workforce Report. Hill & Knowlton, come on down.
I'll keep this short and sweet. Thank you very much on behalf of AFLAC.
If everybody will quiet down, we're going to give away the free Porsche. So pull out your tickets. We're going to do the Corporate Marketer of the Year. I'm sorry, I got confused there. But it did get everybody quiet. That always works. So for the Corporate Marketer of the Year Awards, I'd like to invite Mary back to the stage. Let's give her a big round of applause. It's late in the evening. Get fired up here.
Thank you. All right. I am actually introducing Jennifer Dodson, who's the Director of Advertising for Cricket Wireless. Jennifer Dodson is the head of advertising for Cricket Wireless, the leader in no annual contract space. Jennifer's team is responsible for defining the brand messaging strategy and vision, as well as leading development of all advertising campaigns and activities. She and her team bring to the delightful experience of being a Cricut customer to life through colorful campaign of animated characters. Prior to her current role, Jennifer led local advertising efforts and national campaigns for AT&T Mobility. She was recently appointed to serve on the 2016 AT&T Employee Engagement Council. In addition to her role at Cricut, Jennifer is active with the Girl Scouts of America Association and the Drake House, which provides short-term crisis housing, education, and empowerment programs for homeless mothers and their children. Jennifer is a proud graduate of University of Georgia's Journalism School with a bachelor's degree in public relations. Please help me welcome Jennifer Dodson.
Thank you. I've had the pleasure of working with this person for 10 years, and I have to say, I've seen firsthand how she embodies what we stand for at Cricut, giving you something to smile about. Before I introduce her, though, here's a short video.
I wouldn't be here without the team, and I think what this team has done together is tremendous. And one of those experiences we'll probably never forget, but I'm very proud to be here to represent the team.
I have been so impacted by her personally. To me, she has been this model of a woman who has a family and a career, and she attempts to integrate those in a fashion that are super meaningful.
Her style is, it's so human from a perspective of, it's really about the customer and her employees and her team and the people that work around her. And combining those two things together just creates for an incredible working environment, and then success follows.
I just have an amazing team. They are what I come to work for every single day. They're smart and they're collaborative, and we're all really united by a passion for the business, right? We have a passion for the brand and passion for driving results, and they challenge me every day, and I think we empower each other. I couldn't ask for a better team.
Ladies and gentlemen, your 2016 Corporate Marketer of the Year, Jonna Dusich.
Clamped. Sorry. So thank you. I am super humbled to accept this award. I've been in marketing in some form or fashion for my entire career, but this latest journey at Cricut has been nothing short of amazing. This last year was just groundbreaking for this team. We moved our Net Promoter Score from last place to second in the no-contract space. We set new records in prepaid net ad leadership. And we really just did all of this through this integrated marketing that this team has delivered. And it's really been truly remarkable. But most of all, and I'm glad this came through in the video, I love this team. And we love this brand. And that is the reason that this works. This is truly a team award. So thank you to everyone at Cricut who has contributed to the success of this team and this recognition. We have some folks out here in the audience, so thank you guys. But I'd also like to recognize our business and agency partners. We all share together in this win. I'd like to thank the AMA and the AMI Awards for this recognition and for giving us all the opportunity to celebrate the great work that's going on in Atlanta right now. Thank you so much.
All right, we're in the home stretch. Our next category is multicultural B2B or B2C. We had two categories, B2B or B2C, and we still had one finalist and one winner, Latimer Communications. Be the solution.
Sorry, we were way in the back. But I want to thank the AMA and the AMI Awards for this recognition. I also want to thank Latimer Communications and our fabulous media, creative, production, account services team. And I want to thank our phenomenal client, Georgia Commuter Options, for recognizing the importance of multicultural markets when talking about commute alternatives. And it's telework week, so telework tomorrow.
Thank you.
Okay, our next category is social media campaign for company revenues under $1 billion. We have three finalists: Control Freak, Zombie Face Off. Control Freak seeks huge success with undead photo contests. Nebo, for Nebo brings modern social strategy to timeless brand Turner Classic Movies. And Primrose Schools for Healthy Bodies. And the winner is Primrose Schools.
Thank you. I'll keep it short because I know everyone's getting tired. But thank you to the Primrose internal team. Thank you to our agencies, Blitz Agency, Jackson Spaulding, and Friendly Human, who helped with this as well. So it was definitely collective efforts. Thank you.
Let's not have an accident right here. We're almost done. All right, our next category is social media campaign for companies with revenue over $1 billion. First finalist is Aflac Fleischman Hilliard, positioning an executive as a thought leader. Everywhere Agency, 2015 Supermodel M and Influencer Marketing Activations. And Cardinal Web Solutions for Papa John's National Pizza Month. And the winner is Everywhere Agency, 2015 Supermodel M and Influencer Marketing Activations.
Wow, was not expecting this. Thank you to my amazing team. Honestly, couldn't have done it without you. I love you guys. Go everywhere.
Okay, the next category is web campaign microsite, company revenues under $1 billion. The finalists are Georgia Tech Alumni Association, Georgia Tech Alumni Association's website campaign, Primrose Schools for Primrose Schools, integrated web ecosystem, and Nebo. Nebo launches the ultimate job interview campaign for Choose ATL 2.0. And the winner is Primrose School.
Thank you. This is so exciting. I wanted to thank the entire Primrose Marketing Department, Dodie, Katie, Wendy, Liz, Stephanie, Shannon, our agencies, Jackson Spaulding and Blitz, and so many other people who helped make this project possible. Thank you so much.
Another one who didn't make it to graduate school. That's okay. Okay, now I'd like to bring Mary back up, and she's going to introduce the Agency Marketer of the Year.
I'd like to introduce Krista Lang, who's the SVP Executive Director of Media and Analytics. Krista has had a successful history in leading her teams and clients to deliver on business goals. Her foundation of traditional media experience is enhanced by her 6+ years of digital experience. At 22 Squared, she leads the media, planning, buying, search, and analytics team and works to collaborate across the agency to develop business-driving media and measurement plans for all of their brands. Krista has a wealth of client experience ranging from CPG to financial, retail, across brand and DR, working on national business brands like Nike, Wachovia, Miller Coors, and Microsoft, just to name a few. Her love for advertising comes honestly, and she'll tell you that she was born into the advertising world literally. Her mom was a corporate media director and her dad a sales rep. Please welcome Krista Lang.
Okay, last award of the night. I have the pleasure of introducing the Agency Marketer of the Year. I first met Richard Ward almost 10 years ago when he started at 22 Squared. This was actually right before the name change, so technically it was West Wayne at the time. He was there for about 6 months before I ended up leaving to pursue an opportunity in Seattle. But before I left, Richard had already, you know, was starting to dig in and make some changes that ultimately I'd see the fruits of later. Moving forward a little bit in time, a little over 3 years ago, 22 Squared reached out to me. They were looking for a new media director. Little did I know that I was 9 months pregnant. I had to Skype interview with a few folks, and Richard was one of them. I was very excited to be talking to Richard again. Richard drew me in almost immediately. I knew that West Wayne had evolved into 22 squared, but I was interested in hearing more. Richard shared with me the evolution that he had led the charge on. I was amazed at how he had been able to capture and expand upon that 22 culture from what I had remembered. He was able to solidify that familial vibe that I had felt 7 years prior. Beyond that, during that time, the agency emerged as a real digital powerhouse under Richard's leadership. Because of Richard's passion and resolve to improve upon the agency, it was clear that this was a place I needed to be part of again. Every day since that day 3 years ago, I'm grateful to be working for and with such a powerful and dedicated leader. Please take a look at what I mean.
You know, when I came here, the challenge that I thought was maybe the opportunity of a lifetime was to sort of take the best of what I knew about the agency world and the best of what I knew about the digital world and really put it together in a real hybrid model. And to do that, we really felt like we needed a new brand identity, and that's really where 22 Squared came from.
Richard is a very fearless leader. I think that he's challenging, which I love to be challenged. He's not afraid to blow things up and try something new.
He's good at the finances. He's good at understanding advertising, but what he's best at is understanding people.
He's been a part of these huge explosions of businesses and companies. So just taking the DNA of what he learned there and bringing it to us, I think is fantastic.
So you can see, you can look at the seven pillars of our culture. You look at everything this company's based on and built on. It's built on making better people, you know, not just making great advertising, which is our primary goal, but in the process, he wants to make better people.
You know, when I say it's a labor of love, there's just no other way to describe it. It's just been the journey of a lifetime, and, you know, we're only halfway there. I mean, honestly, the next 10 years will be as exciting, I think, as the last 10.
Please welcome Richard Ward, Agency Marketer of the Year.
10 years ago today was my first day at 22 Squared. You know, I love the quote that it takes a lot of love to create change. And I can honestly say every single day of the last 10 years has been a labor of love. Thank you to the AMA. Mary, you're doing a great job. Thanks to all our people, thanks to our clients, and thanks to all of you. Thanks for the night.
Congratulations, Richard. And he has done an unbelievably transformative job at 22 Squared. So we're at the end of the evening. I want to make sure we thank all of our sponsors again for making the evening possible. I'd also like to let you know you were scheduled to get out of here at 9:45 and we're getting you out before 9 o'clock. So that deserves a round of applause. Thank you all. Have a great evening and a safe drive home.